The whole world was drastically affected by the recent COVID-19 pandemic, which took millions of lives, caused social and emotional upheaval, and disrupted global business for years. It's a reminder that from time to time, existing infectious diseases, as well as new ones, can cause serious outbreaks around the world. That's why it's important to use infectious diseases models when responding to infectious disease outbreaks. Not only have policymakers used them to inform public health responses against COVID-19, but they have also made them available to the public to justify their decisions. But what are infectious disease models, and how can they assist in planning and controlling outbreaks? We all use models in our everyday life. For example, a train timetable lists when trains are expected to arrive based on their departure times, the number of stops, and the average speed of the train. Similarly, an infectious disease model tries to show what might happen in an infectious disease outbreak. If we know how an infectious disease develops and spreads, we can write models using mathematical equations or computer simulations that describe the spread of disease. These models simulate what could happen in an outbreak and how control measures might affect it. How are infectious disease models used? Infectious disease models can be used during an outbreak to project what might happen in the very near future and to see how different control measures, like quarantine and vaccination, might cut down the length of time that an outbreak lasts. Alternatively, they can be used before an outbreak happens to help us plan a response by simulating what might happen in a future outbreak of an unknown disease and identifying the best control measures to implement for this disease. Infectious disease modelers work with teams of people with different skills, such as epidemiologists, public health workers, and clinicians, to make sure that models are tailored to the disease and the specific population. Why should policymakers use infectious disease models in their work? The COVID-19 pandemic will not be the last outbreak or pandemic we will ever witness. With the threat of emerging infectious diseases and the rising prevalence of antimicrobial resistance, it is important to be prepared for any future threat to human health. Infectious disease models are an important tool for policymakers to help them understand what might happen in the future and plan ahead to prevent or control an outbreak. To learn more about infectious disease modelling, visit www.spark.edu.au.